Hi, my name is Marge Weber, and I want to share with you an amazing story of a young man named James Eunice and his parents, John and Tammy. To give you a little background of where I am going with this, on March 15, 2018, our son, Mark, who worked with Special Forces in the United States Air Force, was killed in a helicopter crash while on a rescue mission. For those who have children, you know that the loss of a child is every parent's worst nightmare. Through a series of events, my husband and I connected with John and Tammy. They were like angels sent from God to help us through grief and tragedy. 4 days after Mark's accident, we traveled to the 38th Rescue Squadron at Moody Air Force Base to meet his comrades and have a memorial service to honor him. While walking through the squadron, I noticed a picture of a young man in football gear with a message next to it titled, "The clock is ticking." I quickly took a picture of this message since I was not able to absorb all that was written at that moment. Our family was emotionally and physically exhausted from our tragedy. When I asked the guys at the squadron about this picture, they mentioned that James had written this as a 16-year-old junior following the loss of a friend in a traffic accident. Fast forward about 1 year to January 15, 2011, and James and another friend had gone duck hunting in Ocean Pond. Sadly, during that adventure, James fell out of the boat and was missing for 17 days. The airmen from the 38th Rescue Squadron were instrumental in James's recovery. Mark at this time was finishing his education at the United States Air Force Academy, but would eventually become part of this rescue community at Moody Air Force Base. On our return to Texas, I pulled out James's words, which displayed his character and his love for Christ and people. As I read James's words, I was in awe of his wisdom, so young and wise beyond his years. I wanted to tell his parents that I was so sad to hear about their loss and how much James's message impacted me. As I got into detective mode, I was able to track down John and Tammy, and our stories became intertwined in what Tammy would refer to as the weaving of God's tapestry. After Mark's accident, we received over 30 bins of his belongings. One evening, a thought suddenly popped into my mind. I wondered if one of the papers that I had seen in the midst of these bins was an old registration paper that Mark had filled out for the Clock is Ticking, or TCT, Open Water Swim Event. Each year, the Eunices hold this event to honor their son by sharing James's message and raising funds for college scholarships in his memory. I spoke with Tammy on the phone about the possibility that Mark had swam with them, and within minutes after checking the computer, John said, "Yes, Mark swam our 3.5-mile event and came in first in 2014. Tears filled my eyes as I thought about the significance of our relationship with this family. Mark had met John and Tammy long before my husband and I did. As Tammy and I chatted about God's tender mercies, John searched his computer and again texted pictures to us of that event. In 2014, John and Tammy placed a first place medal on our son, and in 2019, they renamed the event the Mark Weber 3.5-mile Swim. Although the swim event will be virtual this year, I wanted to share the impact that James's story and his parents have on so many people. You never know the ripples of your words or actions that will affect others now or as you leave a legacy. As James would say, take time to love someone today, tomorrow, for the rest of your life. Let others know that you welcome them and you care about them. Don't wait until it's too late.